What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about updating Microsoft Entra Connect Sync and also dealing with Cloud Sync. So let's get right into it. All right, so I logged into my 365 tenant and AD Connect was crying. So what do I mean? So I received this password sync recent synchronization. I got a nice little warning. I was like, what the heck is going on? When I clicked on it, it redirected me to this. It said, upgrade to the latest version of the sync tool using the manage tab, whatever, whatever. And the only reason that I logged into this is because I wanted to check out the cloud sync portion, but I wanted to take care of this. So it's like killing two birds with one stone with this video. So I'm going to show you guys how to upgrade your AD Connect and also install cloud sync, because you're able to have both of these agents running at the same time. And then once you are satisfied with the cloud sync, you're able to cut over to it. But that's going to be for a later video. So again, upgrade to the latest version of the sync tool using the manage tab. So I clicked on that hyperlink here. So once I clicked that, it took me here, which is where I needed to be anyway. So I clicked on manage and I clicked on download connect sync agent. It gave me a nice little side menu. And I clicked on accept terms and download, and it downloaded the MSI. Now, I headed to my domain controller because this is where I have my AD Connect installed, and I dropped that MSI inside the downloads folder. I opened up my synchronization service manager console, and I clicked on help, and I clicked on about. I wanted to know which version I had, and I'm running 2.1.16.0. So once I upgrade, it should be a higher version. I do recommend backing up the config files of your AD Connect if you know how to do that. Because I'm running it inside a virtual machine, I just took a snapshot. So if anything happens with the upgrade, I'm able to use that snapshot and then go back in time when it was, you know, clean and stable. Let's go inside the downloads folder. Let's right click on that MSI file. Let's click on install. It's going to start validating the installation. Once it's done, it's going to load up the Azure AD Connect, and it's going to give you this, upgrade Azure Active Directory Connect. Click on upgrade. It's going to start upgrading the synchronization engine, and it's going to give you this. You need to use a username that has global admin rights within your tenant. Once you provide the username and password, just click on next, and it's going to start getting everything ready. And once it's ready to do what it needs to do, you're going to get this prompt. Just click on upgrade. It's going to start configuring the Microsoft Azure Active Directory Sync, and the upgrade is done, and you're able to exit out. So behind the scenes is actually pushing out an export and a sync for you. But if you open up the Synchronization Service Manager, you are able to click on help, click on about. And now for me, I'm running 2.3.2.0, which is the latest version. When I went back into my tenant, I saw that the sync status was green. Last sync was 0 minutes because, you know, again, once the upgrade is done, it is going to do a full synchronization and the export for you, which is great. Now it is time for us to mess around with cloud sync, because that's the whole reason why I logged into my tenant at, you know, in the first place. So I headed back into this section right here and I clicked on download provisioning agent. Again, it gave me a nice little side menu. I clicked on accept terms and download, and it downloaded the exe file for me. Now, I created a virtual machine called bj-cloudsync, right? Because that's where I'm going to install the agent. You are able to run the cloud sync agent and the AD Connect agent at the same time with no problem, no conflict. That's what I read on the Microsoft site, which is pretty awesome because it allows you to test out before you cut over. So within here, I dropped that exe file within the downloads folder. There it goes. I'm going to select it. I'm going to right click on it, and I'm going to run it as an administrator, and you're going to get this prompt. Just give it a check mark of I agree to the license terms and conditions, and then click on install, and it's going to start processing the agent for you, and you're going to get the nice little wizard. So click next here. You have two options. For what I read online, the HR-driven provisioning is the one that a lot of us are going to use, but you are able to go back and enable additional extensions. But for this video, I am going to enable the first one and then click next. Once you click next, For me in my environment, I got this to log into the portal. Again, this is just like AD Connect. You have to use a global admin account. So provide your email address, hit next, provide your password, click next again, and it should authenticate and take you here. Now you have two options to configure a service account. One is to create or use a custom one. I left it as the default to create one for me. Just provide a domain admin user and a password and then click next there. Make sure that you're connecting to the correct domain. And if you need to provide credentials, add them there. I had all that information already pre-populated for me, which was great. And I click next. A nice little confirmation of what's going to happen. And just click on confirm. It's going to start creating the group managed service accounts. It's going to start registering the agents with Microsoft Entra ID. And then it's going to start restarting the agent, which takes some time. And eventually you're going to get this. Now at the bottom, which I highlighted, it says your agent installation and configuration is completed, which is great, but please complete all your provisioning configuration using the Microsoft Entra ID portal. So you can start syncing stuff to Azure because you just install an agent, but you got to create a profile to actually tell it what you want to sync. So we're going to exit out of this. You're going to get this success, which is great. Close out of that. Now, if you open up Active Directory and you go inside Manage Service Accounts folder, you're going to see basically the account that was created during the Cloud Sync installation. Now, if you don't see that folder, just make sure you click on View and click on Advanced Features or something like that to see the rest of the folders within your Active Directory. Now, if you head back inside your Microsoft Entra Admin Center, if you click on Cloud Sync, this is where later on, I'm going to show you guys how to create a configuration profile so you can start telling it what type of stuff you want synced up to the cloud. But if you go inside agents, you will see your agent and you will see your external IP and the status, which is active, which is awesome. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.